morning and welcome.
Good morning.
May the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
And grace and peace to us all in the name of Christ our Lord. He calls us to this time of worship on this All Sunday. It is a blessing to be with each of you in this time of worship. Thank you for beginning your week on this day of worship by sharing this time at First Church. We're blessed by the presence of each of you, especially those guests and visitors who may be with us. And just a reminder of the registration pads that you find to your right or left that helps us for you to sign those pads. We begin the most significant week of the church year this morning. We are grateful for the leadership of our children, our choirs, in this time of worship. I want to express a word of gratitude to the choir that's been working extra diligently in preparation for this week, in preparation for Holy Week, Easter, also for their leadership in a service of the Lord's activity. Thank you, choir. You're inspired. You're blessed more than you know. Aren't we? If you have not looked in the breezeway, where many of our flowers are kept, you'll see some artwork that has been produced for this week by our children. You'll want to take a look at that. And also, as we begin worship next Sunday, Brass 5 will be a part of that time of worship. And they will begin a time of prelude, that service of worship, at 10:45. Just a reminder that you may want to find your place here in the sanctuary on Easter morning at 10:45 for that gift of music. Just a reminder as well, the midweek service will be held here at noon on Wednesday. Bonnie Lee Whip, the local hospital, will lead us in that time of worship. We gather here Monday, Thursday evening. We gather for the crosswalk at noon on Good Friday. Then we gather in our chapel for a service of tenebrae at 7 o'clock on Good Friday before finding ourselves here next Sunday morning at 7 o'clock for the sunrise service with a breakfast to follow. Again, the most significant week of the church year for us as people of faith. We find ourselves at the cross. We find ourselves finally with the good news that God overcomes death. I hope we will share these times of worship that are before us this week. Be prepared to worship God now.
Thank you.
hear the word of God as it comes to us from Luke, the 19th chapter. When he had said this, he went on ahead, going up to Jerusalem. When he drew near to Bethphage and Bethany at the mount that is called Olivet, he sent two of his disciples, saying, "Go into the village opposite, where on entering you will find a colt tied on which no one has ever yet sat. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, 'Why are you untying it?' you shall say this, 'The Lord has need of it.'" So those who were sent went away and found it as he had told them. And as they were untying the colt, its owners said to them, "Why are you untying the colt?" And they said, "The Lord has need of it." And they brought it to Jesus. And throwing their garments on the colt, they set Jesus upon it. And as he rode along, they spread their garments on the road. As he was now drawing near at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice, to praise God with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen, saying, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest." Some of the Pharisees and the multitude said to him, "Teacher, rebuke your disciples." He answered, "I tell you, if these were silent, the very stones would cry out." This is the word of our Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We stand as we share in our call to worship. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
God's steadfast love endures forever.
Hosanna, blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest heaven.
The Lord is our God, and has given us light.
Great is our God, and give thanks to the Lord.
The Lord is our God, and has given us light. Great is our God, and we give thanks to the Lord. Hosanna to the Son of David.
Hosanna, save us, God. Hosanna, our steadfast love to yours forever.
Thank you.
go to God with our opening prayer. God of the cross, pottering down the streets of Jerusalem on the dawn, you are not the Savior we expect. Your power is just like the power we want our God to have. We are happy to join the crowd, waving branches, but not so sure we will follow you through this holy week, into the temple courts, into the upper room, into the garden of Gethsemane, the high priest's house, the assembly of elders, the pile, the area, to the place of the skull, to the foot of the cross. We need you to go with us on this journey. Grant us clear vision, courageous hearts, persistent steps. Even though we know what this week will bring, we sing Hosanna, Hosanna, save us.
Just one more week if we can make it. It won't be easy. The hosannas we shout today will soon fade away. These hosannas will soon give way to the shouts of the crucified. We will find ourselves in the company of the disciples who abandoned Jesus. We may deny like Peter. We may betray like Judas. We may want nothing to do with Jesus like Pontius Pilate. We feel like Barabbas, as we see Jesus die in our hearts. Again, this will not be an easy week as we sit at the table with Jesus the night before he dies. As we see Jesus die on the cross for us. So, the Bible tells us Jesus suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, buried. The Bible tells us before there can be a resurrection, Jesus will first die. And at the heart of it all, the words proclaim this Palm Sunday are for our trip. Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Jesus, thank you for loving us so much that you gave your life for us. You come to us humbly riding on a donkey, sent by God to save us all. We pray that we follow you to the cross where we see how much you love us all.
Thank you.
second chapter we pray. Pour your Spirit upon us, O Lord, in this time of worship, that we hear above all the word you proclaim, that we may know the word become flesh and dwell among us, even unto the cross. Amen. Have this mind among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus. For though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Therefore God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. This is the word of our Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Thank you. The first truth carried to a carpenter shop.
Thank you.
stand, I invite us to affirm our faith by words of scripture from 1 Timothy number 8:89. There is one God, and there is one mediator, Christ Jesus, who came as a ransom for all to whom we testify.
Thank you.
petitions that I speak with the words, Lord, in your mercy, and invite you the response to hear our prayer, and invite you to name as well those concerns you bring with you to this time of worship. Now the prayer, as I offer it, will be appropriate through this Palm Sunday. Again, the responses will remain the same. And we conclude this time of prayer with our Lord's Prayer. Let us pray. Christ, we pray that you would hear our prayers and graft in our minds the same mind that is in you, that we might be vessels of your humility and grace. Lord Jesus, you emptied yourself, trading in the form of God for the form of a slave. We pray for the church and all her people and ministers. Form us into a church that empties itself for others and for you. Lord, in your mercy. Lord Jesus, you were born in human likeness and found in human form. We pray for the whole human family, for the nations of the earth, for all who live in the midst of disaster, famine, or terror. Lord, in your mercy. Lord Jesus, even after humbling yourself in your incarnation, you humbled yourself even to the point of death. We pray for our nation, our leaders, and all the people who live within this land. Bless us with your humility, Lord, and your mercy. Lord Jesus, your humility and your love for us was so broad and deep it cost you your life. We pray for those who we love, who have died, and as you were highly exalted, may they rest with you in glory. Lord, in your mercy, in your exaltation, O Lord, you were given the name that is above every name. We pray in your name for those who are poor, those who are hungry, those who are hurting in any way. Give them your grace, Lord, and your mercy. We also pray in your name, O Lord, for those who may be ill, hurting, hospitalized. Give them the gift of healing, strength, and life, Lord, in your mercy. You humbled yourself in the manger, and you humbled yourself on the cross. And to you, O Lord, we bend our knee, with those above and those below, to the glory of God the Father, praying as Christ has taught us, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, for know the presence of this royal king. We've been blessed by the voices of our children. We've been inspired. Again, thanks to our children, Elizabeth Holt and Sherry Bell, for your leadership as choir brothers. And we go now as a light into God's world, as a light into this community and beyond, following the Christ who has humbled himself even to the cross. We go now in the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit.